Namaskaram. Ever since I started learning Shukla Yajurveda, it was my desire to write and document the complete Samhita and Padapatha of Kanva Samhita of Shukla Yajurveda, error-free and in a big font along with complete details. Though this Shaka Samhita is smaller in size compared to Rigveda and Krishna Yajurveda, Taittiriya Shaka, there is no authentic book available in the market to learn this Veda error-free. The students have to make suitable corrections to their old material while learning this Samhita and Padapatha. These books give the entire Samhita Pata and complete Padapatha, including the Galita or Gananda Padas, so that students can have a better understanding about how the Samhita is formed with Padas. This book starts with detailed introduction note in English about Shukla Yajurveda, its various branches, various Sikshas, history of Yajnavalkya, Janaka, etc. Most importantly, this book includes my research in Shukla Yajurveda, highlighting its special features and uniqueness while reciting and highlighting its chanting rules compared to Rigveda and Krishna Yajurveda. This also includes my observations on Gananda Padas, Vakhyanda Veshtana and the reasons why Kramapatha is not a Prakriti Patha, at least when it comes to Shukla Yajurveda, with suitable examples. Kindly note, this is the only Veda Samhita in which the Pada, that is the word, Om, Pranava is appearing twice, and the Upanishad appears in the Samhita Patha itself. This Upanishad is the Ishavasya Upanishad, for which Vikriti Patha like Jata or Ghana Patha can be recited. This Samhita has 40 Adhyayas or chapters, and we have made 2 volumes of 20 Adhyayas each. As of now, there is no book available in the world detailing the total number of Padas, Suddha Padas and Gananda Padas, Anuvakam wise, chapter wise, etc. Further, this is the only book in the world containing the Kanva Shaka Samhita with complete Padapatha, including the Gananda Padas, side by side to have a proper and complete understanding of this Veda. I have spent more than 15 years in preparing the book with all the details, especially to prepare an alphabetical index of all the lines of these mantras so that the learners can identify them easily. This was the most time-consuming part and required a lot of effort in compiling them. A detailed table showing number of mantras, number of lines, number of total padas, Gananda padas, Suddha padas in each chapter is given. Another table detailing the total number of lines beginning from each alphabet is also given. Now, let me highlight some of the features of this book. The Samhita is given in the left hand side and the corresponding padas are given in the right side for easy reference and understanding. The Galita or Gananda padas are marked separately in grey color so that the students can easily identify the Galita padas and Suddha padas. The Samhita portion are numbered with Adhyaya, that is, chapter number, mantra number of the chapter, and the number of sentences in each mantra like A, B, C, D, E, etc. Each mantra in the Anuvaka is numbered separately, which is given at the end of the mantra. Anuvaka number is given at the end of each Anuvaka, number in bracket after the last mantra. At the end of each chapter, the Anuvaka's starting word, pada, along with the number of mantras of that Anuvaka is given. In the same place, the total Anuvakas of that chapter and the total number of mantras are also given in Sanskrit in the Samhita section. In the Pada section, each mantra is numbered in that Anuvaka. At the end of each Anuvaka, the total number of Padas of that Anuvaka less the Galita or the Ganantha Pada in that Anuvaka, and hence we get the total number of Shuddha Padas of that Anuvaka. At the end of each chapter, an Anuvaka-wise detailed table is given showing the total Padas, Galita Padas and Shuddha Padas. A detailed search table alphabetically for each sentence, not mantra alone, are given in the annexure for all 4,640 sentences. When there is a change or modification between Samhita and Padapada, both Samhita format and Pada format is given in brackets, which must be considered as single Pada for counting purpose. This is very useful while reciting Vikriti Patas. Vakhyanta Veshtana, that is, ending of sentences, is indicated with star mark in the Pada text. So, the Krama, Jata, Gana, etc. has to be recited for those group of words till the star mark, even though the sentence has ended as per Samhita text. Suitable Avagraha and Visarga is included in the Samhita based on the Padas, which are given in the right hand side, so that students can understand the proper Sandhi, which is very unique in this book. There are few Shukla Yajurveda Patashalas in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Gujarat and Maharashtra, etc., who do not even have proper books on this Shaka. It is very important to have this book in your home, irrespective of your own Veda Shaka. You may be belonging to Rigveda or Krishna Yajurveda or Samaveda, but that does not mean you cannot have this book. In fact, I belong to Krishna Yajurveda, Taittiriya Shaka, but I have 3 versions of Taittiriya Shaka books, 3 versions of Rigveda Shakla Shaka book, 1 version of Ashvarana Shaka of Rigveda, 2 versions of Shukla Yajurveda, 2 versions of Samaveda, 3 versions of Atharvaveda. Unfortunately, people have a mentality of not patronizing other Vedas, which I hope will change. I hope you would get this book and keep it in your home or puja room and give patronage to such a rare shaka like Kanva Shaka. This book will be very useful whenever you have a desire to learn the Veda. Further, there will be some common mantras and some special mantras. For example, the Shiva Sankalpa mantras are only from Shukla Yajurveda, though you are reciting as part of Mahanyasam in Krishna Yajurveda. We request you to extend your highest patronage to this book by buying adequate quantities for your learning and gift it to the students of Veda Patashala or libraries, and can also recommend to your groups. You can order this book by clicking the link given below in the description or visit ganapati.com. We thank you for your support and patronage, recognizing and appreciating the hard work deployed in propagating the very ancient oral tradition of ours. Thank you. Namaskaram.